The MH-60J Instructor Pilot Course Operational Flight Trainer Module has been designed for the purposes of enabling the instructor to operate the 60J OFT in a manner that facilitates a high-fidelity training environment. As such, the course has been centered on six identified tasks the instructor must perform in order to use the OFT to facilitate this training environment. These tasks are to 1. Conduct a student briefing. 2. Determine the operational status of the trainer. 3. Perform trainer boarding procedures. 4. Prepare the trainer for the training session. 5. Conduct a flight training session from the IOS. 6. Terminate a training session. These tasks are detailed in a series of handouts provided to IUTs upon arrival at Aviation Training Center Mobile for the IP course. The handouts form the core of the instruction for the OFT module, and it is expected that IUTs will read them prior to the start of the OFT module of the IP course, using them as a reference for the module's duration. In reading the handouts, IUTs will often be referred to the MH-60J OFT Instructor Utilization Handbook, or IUH. The IUH is essentially the equipment manual for the OFT, and the IUH sections referred to in the handouts should also be read prior to the start of the OFT module of the IP course. The IUH is another excellent reference for IPs operating the OFT. Each of the task handouts is divided into several parts. After the cover page, each task is introduced to the reader by stating the task's purpose, audience, and usability. Following this, the task's Terminal Performance Objective, or TPO, and Enabling Objectives, or EOs, are listed. These objectives determine the framework for the next section of the handout, a sequential listing of the steps and sub-steps involved in performing each of the six tasks. Where necessary, reference materials have been included in each of the task handouts. Examples of reference materials include locations of the OFT interlocks, safety features, completed simulator pink sheet forms, and instructions regarding software and hardware features of the OFT important to the 60J OFT instructor. Given that the IUT should have read the reading material prior to the start of the IP course OFT module, the IUT's focus during the module is on practicing and mastering the tasks involved to use the simulator to facilitate a safe, salient, and high-fidelity training environment. Note that some of the content included in this module serves as a placeholder until the OFT undergoes its upcoming transformation from a 60J to a 60T. The module includes six lessons, OFT 1 through 6. OFT 1, OFT Operations, is a lesson designed for the IP and the IUT to practice each task and all the steps involved with each task together. No student pilots are present for this lesson. The IP and IUT may use this session to plan out the rest of the course module. In OFT 2, Emergency Procedures, student pilots are present. The IUT sits at the IOS at this point and focuses on mastering the management of the OFT's procedures. In addition to running the IOS, the IUT may run the scenario for the students as well, inserting appropriate targets and role-playing as desired. This should only be done where both the IP and the IUT feel confident in the IUT's ability to run the scenario, as, again, the focus of these first sessions is on mastering the expected maneuvers and procedures through practice. OFT 3, Op Scenario, and OFT 4, Instrument Check, are very similar to OFT 2 in that they both provide the IUT practice at the IOS and the opportunity to teach the students. As the course progresses, less supervision and guidance from the IEP should be required, and the IUT should be leading more and more of the scenario. In lessons OFT 5, Op Scenario IUT Check, and OFT 6, Instrument Check IUT Check, the IUT is now acting completely as the IP, and the supervising IP's job is to observe and grade the IUT's performance by task. In these last lessons, the IUT fills out the student pilot's daily progress reports, or DPRs, records ALMIS OFT flight data, and conducts the briefing and debriefing in addition to running the OFT. The supervising IP grades the IUT on his or her mastery of the defined tasks. The IUT is provided feedback regarding his or her performance through DPRs. To complete a DPR, the IP first opens the OFT DPR file indicated on the H60 Instructor Utility website. Once the file is opened, the IP saves the file as the IUT's last name, positioning a copy of the file on the IP's portable hard drive. Note that this file can be opened from the IOS directly, giving instructors the ability to write directly on the form in the IOS HUD. Of course, as the IoT will be in the hut with the IP during this time, it may be prudent to print a copy of the DPR, writing comments upon it throughout each lesson, before transferring the information to the digital copy of the DPR. Next, the IP fills out the form's identifying information, including the IoT's name and unit, the IP's name, the date the event took place, and whether or not the event was completed, along with a general summary of the event. The IP then ensures that all of the maneuvers and procedures are evaluated correctly. The IP only needs to change a grade when the student's performance was either different from the standard or the maneuver or procedure was not conducted or completed. If the maneuver was not conducted or completed, select DNC. If several maneuvers and procedures are not conducted or completed, it may be necessary to have another session to evaluate these incomplete maneuvers or procedures. If this is the case, another column has been provided. Simply select the date for the second session at the top of the second column, and then fill in the appropriate information. On this DPR, a comments section enables the IP to provide feedback to the students regarding specific evaluated maneuvers and/or procedures. These comments begin with the specific number of the maneuver or procedure. Note that these comments automatically form hanging indentations. Only press Enter when you are ready to move on to a new comment. Comments should appear in close proximity to the maneuvers or procedures they are commenting upon. On this DPR, the branch chief or the branch reviewer, who is typically the standardization officer or STANO, is able, if he or she so desires, to provide feedback on IoT performance via this text field. The IP provides more comments, feedback, and recommendations in a section that includes at least one page of writing space. Note that these fields automatically indent paragraphs. On all text fields on this form, writing is limited to the visible area. When the DPR is completed, the IP digitally signs and dates the DPR as the evaluator. The IP then saves the form again before sending it to the branch reviewer. Again, this is typically the STANO. The evaluator's signature does not block the form. This enables the branch reviewer to make any necessary changes or comments. Branch reviewers then provide the date before digitally signing the form, as a reviewer's signature locks all fields on the form. If more than one session is required for a lesson to complete all of the maneuvers or procedures, and the second IP is different from the first IP, this can be indicated prior to having the reviewer sign the form by writing something like the following in the branch chief or branch reviewer comments. IP's name took IUT's name on OFT flight with students to complete this flight's requirements. IUT's name either met or exceeded the standards. This has been a tour of the 60J IP course OFT module. If there are any questions, contact your branch chief or experienced IPs within your branch.